गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर प्लेसेस. माई सेल्फ मिस सुरभि शर्मा फ्रॉम शिवज्योति एजुकेशनल ग्रुप कोटा. सो चिल्ड्रेन, एज यू ऑल नो, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 7. ओके, सो लेट स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर. सो आर चैप्टर इज चैप्टर 7, दैट इज ट्राइब्स, नोमैड्स एंड सेटल्ड कम्युनिटीज. नाउ व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय दिस ट्राइब्स? Who were the tribes? Tribes were the Adivasis. Okay, if we talk about the tribes, they were the Adivasis. Okay, then nomads were there. Nomads were the those who used to travel from one place to another with their animals. Okay, so those were the nomadic herders. Okay, and settled communities were the ones who got settled after traveling from one place to another. See, in this chapter what we are going to study is about these categories. Okay, till now what we have covered in history, we have covered the Mughal Empire, Delhi Sultans, okay, all such the empires, about kingdoms, okay, we have covered, okay, how they raised up their empire and how they fell down. We talked about the Delhi Sultans, okay, they set up their empire, but after a period of time they declined. Okay, same when we started with the Mughal Empire. Okay, after Aurangzeb, Mughal Empire also got declined. Okay, then other communities were there, Brahmins communities were there, then Rajputs were there. So in all, we all just studied about such people, such empires, kingdoms, rulers. Okay, but have we thought what was happening in the forest areas? Okay, who were living in the forest areas? So these kind of people were living in the forest areas. Now just to think, when the empires were declining, how much it was affecting to the rulers? जिनके भी empire decline हो रहे थे, how much they were getting affected from such attacks and all? Okay, they were standing up the army for their enemies and all. They were fighting. Okay, they were opposing. But have you ever thought what they did? How they have control over their areas? इनका एरिया कौन सा था? The forest in which they were living. Okay, see, tribes, आदिवासीज, generally they were living in the forest areas. Then nomads, those who were traveling with their animals from one place to another. So basically what kind of areas they were cover? They were covering the forest areas. Then settled communities, some communities were there who got settled at some particular place, like they stopped migrating and they settled at some particular place and set up their agricultural fields. Okay, so when people started capturing their areas, when people start capturing their areas, how they got affected? Okay, what kind of things, what kind of scope they got, yeah, what they did when people tried to capture their area. So about all such things we are going to read about in this chapter. Okay, we are going to read about who were tribal peoples, who were the nomads, and who were the settled communities. Okay, so kindly open up your books and keep pencils in your hand. You saw in chapter 2, 3 and 4 how kingdoms rose and fell. Okay, Mughal Empire was there. Okay, Mughal Empire was there. Okay, then one more example I can give you, that was the Delhi Sultans were there. Okay, how they set up their empire and declined. Okay, even as this was happening, new arts, crafts and production activities flourished in towns and villages. Over the centuries, important political, social and economic developments had taken place. What kind of developments had taken place? Political, social and economic developments had taken place. But now the question arises, do these developments were same everywhere? These developments were there in the forest areas also? No, but social change was not the same everywhere, because different kinds of societies evolved differently. It is important to understand how and why this happened. In large parts of the subcontinent, society was already divided according to the rules and rules of Varna. Now, rules of Varna, okay. See what happened. According to Varna system, our society got divided into caste system. Kshatriyas were there, then Brahmins, okay, then Shudras, okay. So, on the basis of their castes, our society got divided. These rules as prescribed by the Brahmins were accepted by the rulers of large kingdoms. Now, the rules which were made by the Brahmins, okay, the rules which were prescribed by the Brahmins were accepted by the rulers of other kingdoms also. Okay, large kingdoms also. Okay, jo bhi rules Brahmins bana rahe the, those rules and regulations were accepted by the large kingdoms also. The difference between the high and the low and between the rich and poor increased under the Delhi Sultans. Now, when the difference between the rich and the poor and high and the low increased, the gap, the difference, okay, when this difference got emerged, this difference got emerged during the Delhi Sultans. Okay, in chapter 3 we have read about Delhi Sultans. Okay, so during the Delhi Sultanate period, these difference got emerged and it got increased. So under the Delhi Sultans and the Mughals, this hierarchy between social classes grew further. Okay, we have read about the Delhi Sultans also and about the Mughal Empire also. But if you remember, Akbar tried to lower down this gap. Do you remember how Akbar started recruiting the people from diverse background? So Akbar was the one who tried to lower down this gap between the rich and the poor, between the low and the high class people. Okay, he tried to remove this gap between these people, but somewhere he failed. Now, beyond big cities, tribal societies, okay, the societies of Adivasis. There were, however, other kinds of societies as well. Many societies in the subcontinent did not follow the social rules and rituals prescribed by the Brahmins. As we have just now talked, see, these Brahmins, they were making the rules and regulations which were accepted by the people of large kingdom. But many tribal societies, they were not following these rules and regulations prescribed by the Brahmins. Nor were they divided into numerous unequal classes. Such societies are often called tribes. Okay, now or these societies, these tribal societies, they were not being divided. Like I have told you, according to Varna system, our society got divided into various sub castes. Okay, Brahmins were there, then Kshatriyas, Shudras. Okay, but what was very good about these tribal societies were they never got such kind of things in their mind. They were equal. Okay, you can underline these lines. They divided into numerous unequal classes. Such societies are often called tribes. Okay, mark it from here. Many societies in the subcontinent did not follow the social rules and rituals prescribed by the Brahmins, nor were they divided into numerous unequal classes. Such societies are often called tribes. Okay, so is it very clear who were the tribes? They were very different from the Brahmin society. Okay, they were not following any rules and regulation prescribed by the Brahmin society. Members of each tribe were united by kinship bonds. Now, what was kinship bonds? According to kinship bonds, everyone is equally treated. Okay, everyone is equally treated. There was nothing like upper caste or lower caste. There was nothing like rich or poor. Okay, so they were united by the kinship bonds. Like for them, everyone was equal. Many tribes obtained their livelihood from agriculture. Other were hunter gatherers or herders. Okay, most often they combine these activities to make full use of the natural resources of the area in which they lived. Because for these tribal people, what was the main livelihood? Like what was their income? They were earning income by such sources only. Okay, they were the hunters. Okay, and they were the gatherers. Like they were gathering the fruits, vegetables, and other eatables from different areas they were traveling to. Okay, some tribes were nomadic and moved. Yes, some tribes were nomadic and moved from one place to another. okay? Nomadic herders, nomads, those who were traveling from one place to another with their animals. A tribal group controlled land and pastures jointly and divided these amongst household according to its own rules. According to its own rules, that means rules which were not prescribed by the Brahmins. Okay, these rules, they were made by these only. Okay, rules made by these communities only, these tribal communities only. Many large tribes thrived in different parts of the subcontinent. They usually lived in forest. Okay, they generally live in the remote areas. Okay, remote areas, the areas which are far away from the city areas. Forest, hills, deserts and places difficult to reach. Sometimes they clashed with the more powerful caste-based society. More powerful caste-based society, here you will read in further chapter, okay, in the further topic, that how they clashed with the Brahmin society. Okay, you know what will happen? Brahmins will try to capture their areas in which they are residing. Their forest areas, Brahmins will try to capture. Okay, now how they clashed with the more powerful caste-based society? See, there was something, okay, in which like they were engaged in barter system. Few of the forest things, the things which are available in the forest, they were giving to the Brahmins, and what they were getting in return from the Brahmins, the things which they need, or the cash or the money. Okay, they were selling out their forest produce, okay, to the Brahmins, and they were getting the money back from the Brahmins. So sometimes some other grains or some other things which were not available in the forest, they were getting it from the Brahmins. So this is how they both were dependent upon each other. Okay, if we talk about tribals, okay, they were dependent upon Brahmins. Okay, they were dependent upon Brahmins. And if we talk about the Brahmins, Brahmins were also dependent upon the tribal communities. Okay, Brahmins. Okay, so this is how they clashed with each other, and this is how they were dependent on each other. In various ways, the tribes retained their freedom and preserved their separate culture. Okay, in various ways, like they never wanted that someone, Brahmins, would ever capture them, or they never wanted to join some other big communities. They were having their own communities, own rules and regulations, and they just want to work according to their rules and regulations. But the caste-based and tribal societies also dependent on each other. मैंने जो आपको बताया अभी, dependent on each other for their diverse needs. Okay, why they were clashing? Why they were dependent upon each other for their diverse needs, for fulfilling their diverse needs. This relationship of conflict and dependence gradually caused both societies to change. Okay, this their dependence raised the conflict. Okay, like this relationship, or you can say conflict and dependence on each other, gradually caused both societies to change. You know what will happen at the end? At the end, these Brahmin communities, these Brahmin societies will ask the tribal societies to leave their culture and join the Brahmin societies. Why? Because Brahmins will try to capture these forest areas also. Okay, so this was how tribals are living and how Brahmins will be capturing their areas, and how they have to, at the end of the chapter, will have to join the Brahmin society. So introduction I have already given. Okay, that was beyond big cities, tribal societies. I have explained you. Okay, now who were tribal people? Okay, these are the topics that we are going to cover today. Then who were tribal people? Tribal people practice primitive cultivation. Primitive cultivation, that means like they used to grow crops or other eatables only for themselves or only for their family members. Like they were not growing or they were not doing the cultivation or agriculturing part for the selling purposes. Okay, like they were doing cultivation only for themselves. Then remote regions, they are generally found in the remote regions. Okay, found in remote areas, that is away from the city areas. They have self-made rules. Self-made rules, that means, see, I have told you, Brahmins tried to capture them. Brahmin society was also there. They have their own rules and regulations. But these tribal people, they never followed their rules. They have self-made rules. Whatever was there in their societies, their communities, whatever they were following, okay, they were following according to their own made rules. Didn't follow Brahmanical rules of society, okay. The rules which were prescribed, which was made by the Brahmins, were followed by the large kingdoms, but those rules were not followed by these tribal people. Followed kinship principle. Kinship principle, I have right now explained you. Principle of equality. Like if you remember, according to the Varna system, there was so much of equality in the caste system. Caste system was made, okay. But in tribal communities, there was no such caste system. They treated each and every one of them equally. So they were following the kinship principle. Okay. Now next, nomadic communities, nomadic tribes, pastoral nomads, and Banjaras. Okay, these are the nomadic communities, those who were traveling from one place to another. Next, we are going to cover this nomadic communities. Okay, yes, nomad communities or nomadic communities. Okay, nomadic tribes, pastoral nomads, and Banjaras we are going to cover. Okay, so let's start. Nomadic tribes. Who were the nomadic tribes? Traveled place to place for livelihood along with their cattle, along with their animals. Then exchanged animal products for grain, textile, etc. with settled communities. Okay, with settled communities. Okay, they were exchanging their grains, their produce, their textile with the settled communities. If you remember, in the starting only tribes were there. Nomads were there and settled communities were there. So these nomads, they used to exchange their products with the settled communities. Then Gujars, Bakarwals, Bhotias, Garuliyas, Lahars, and Gadis, some important nomadic tribes. So these are the names of the nomadic tribes. Now, who were pastoral nomads? Yes, pastoral nomads traveled long distances with their animals. See, they are all the nomads. Only slight difference is there between them. Okay, they long distance with their animals, lived on animal products. Okay, in the previous, we have read like they were exchanging their grains, their textiles. But if we read about pastoral nomads, they generally deal with the animal products only. They lived on the animal products like milk, meat, and other products. Sold animals, ropes, reeds, straw matting, and coarse sack. Okay, so generally they were selling these kind of items. Now, Banjaras. Yes, important trader nomads. They were the most important trader nomads. Okay, traded mainly in food stuffs, moved with their families and goods in caravans, lived in large temporary camps called tanda. Okay, they lived in large temporary camps. Temporary camps, that means that is not permanent. Okay, that was known as tanda, and transported food supplies and grains during Sultanate and Mughal period. Okay, so see about these Banjaras, these trading group, we have read about them in the previous chapters also. Okay, so these were the tribal groups. They were the nomads and they were transferring the food supplies, goods to the Sultanate and Mughal during the Sultanate and Mughal period also. Okay, so they were the nomadic communities. Okay children, now mark internal questions. Come on page number 92. Open page number 92. Write down the question there. Who were nomadic tribes? Okay, page number 92 pe you will get the answer. Sixth line, tribes were nomadic and moved from one place to another. Okay, tribes were nomadic and moved from one place to another. Okay, marked internal question number 1. Then come on page number 95. Write down the question there. Who were most important trader nomads? Yes, tell me, who were the most important trader nomads? Just now we have read about them. Banjaras. Okay, in the first line only, page number 95, second paragraph, first line, you will find the answer. The Banjaras were the most important trader nomads. Okay, marked all of you? Have you all marked? I am again repeating the question, who were the most important trader nomads? Okay, so children, I hope you all have marked the questions carefully. We have completed with the half chapter, and in the further topics, the next topic of this chapter we will be covering in the part 2. This was the part 1 of your chapter number 7, history. Okay, in part 2 we are going to cover the further topics. Okay children, so this was all for today. I hope you all understood each and everything. Okay, be prepared for the live session. Thank you.